Hey, welcome to this section on control charts. Before we talk about control charts, let's talk about variation. There is variation in anything and everything. No two people are alike. No two fingerprints are same. And when you are manufacturing, all your components might not be same. These are different. Even though the variation is minor, but each component is different. For example, if you are making an item which is weighing 100 grams, not every item will be 100 grams. If you go to a number of decimal levels, you will see that one of the item might be 99.997 gram, another item might be 99.999 grams, or another item might be 100.001 gram. So there is always a difference in the weight. That is because of variation. You cannot avoid variation, but then you need to keep control on that to make sure that this variation does not take your items or your product outside the acceptable range. And that is where control charts come into picture. Control charts are used to differentiate between a common cause and a special cause. Common cause is something which we talked that components are different. So things will be changing from 99.9 and 7 to 99.999 or 100.001. This could be because of the natural variation, inherent variation of the process. But when things change, then you need to be alerted that something has changed now and this requires action. So to differentiate between the common cause and special cause, you need a tool, and that tool is control chart. In this section, we'll be learning about various types of control charts, and different types of control charts are used for different type of data. We will go through that in this section. So we will be learning about X bar R chart, X bar S chart, NP chart, P chart, C chart, and U chart. Where all these are used and how these are used. And in addition to theory of these, I will demonstrate how do we use Minitab to draw these control charts. So with this understanding, let's get started and learn about control charts in this section.